All right, here's a little knife that I made. It's a carving knife. I seen them make them online before, so I figured I'd try to do it. I was going to try to do a little woodworking. Now, this in here, I wanted to be a little different on the handle, so I made it look like a finger. It actually looks like my finger, just a little bit bigger, I guess, because I was looking at my finger and cutting finger out there. So I'm going to try to make another one. Maybe I'll carve it into a different looking finger. But that's what it looks like, and the blade is basically it's a sawzall blade. I'll show you what I started with. When I started building this, I took a piece of firewood, which this is walnut, and I took this piece of walnut and I have whittled it down. I got one of them I forget what it was, a draw knife, and I took it and stuck it in a vise, and I got it to look like this, and I drilled a 3/8 hole in there. And then I took a sawzall blade, just like this, and made my knife in it. And I cut this 3/8 thick here. Then I took a piece of dowel and shoved it down on both sides of that and glued it. And so we're going to make one, and I'll see if I can show you guys how I made it. And maybe you can make your own. All right, this is the knife that I carved out and made it look like a finger. It actually don't look too bad, but I didn't have a carving knife, so I just used a razor blade knife, and that's what I come up with. And right in here is where I put the dowel. I put dowel down in there, and there's a little piece of dowel down in there, and then I slid that down and glued it. But I think my blade's going to be okay. I still got to do a little bit of work to that blade. But for a first time knife, I don't think it looks too bad. And I thought being different on the handle, hey, what the heck? Why just do a regular old handle? If it's a carving knife, carve your handle. So that's what I did. Okay, let's get to working on the carving knife. Now the first thing, we got our firewood, of course. Piece of old scrap wood. And then this is walnut. And it was already pretty much split. I just took a little coping saw and cut me a chunk off. I just took a coping saw and cut me a chunk off. I didn't use any power tools or nothing there. And then once I got in a block like this, I took one of these draw knives and I just kept going until I got me a round piece of wood. Now, not everybody has one of these draw knives, but I'll tell you, if you could pick one up at a yard sale or a flea market, they actually work pretty good. I mean, to make this thing as round as you can. And it's all about pretty much doing it with your hand. So anyhow, like I said, I whittled it down and I ended up with a piece like this. Then I took a 3/8 drill bit and drilled this hole. I tried to get in there as center as I could. So that's what we got so far. Before we start carving on this, I want to find out exactly the depth that I drilled my hole in there. So I just put a little piece of rod down in there and I got it about that deep. So I'm going to make a mark on here. So if I want to carve a finger or whatever I'm going to do with this thing, I don't want to cut down into that hole that we drilled in there. So we got it marked right here, and we'll start whittling this out a finger out of this thing. I'm gonna do a different finger this time. I'm gonna do the same one. We'll do something a little different. We got a lot of the big stuff off of this finger handle. We're just going to whittle down into that finger. So it'll take a little while, but I'll keep working at it. I just want to try to get the shape of the finger. This one here, I'm going to bend this finger a little bit more. I'm going to try to bend it just a little bit more instead of having it so straight like the other one. So it'll be a little different. I'm trying to get the fingernail about the shape I want the fingernail. I'm just trying to get the general shape of that finger. I want this one to be a little more rough looking, more older finger Just something that'll look a little different. And I only have one carving knife, so this is the one I made. I'm trying to make a different one, so I'll have different carving knives, you know. So I'm trying to do it as best I can. Like I said, I'm not much of a carver. And boy, this end of that wood is really hard to carve into. Now, I sanded all that wood on this one and made it smooth. I kind of like the finished look smooth. Although it wouldn't look like I carved it, but hey. Oh well. You can do yours whatever way you want. Never liked using wood too much because wood is not very forgiving. If I mess this nail up, I gotta start all over. If this was metal, mess the nail up, I just weld it back up and redo it again. But anyhow, it's working. See, we're just trying to get the shape of that nail. We're hoping to make a finger sort of bent, you know, try to get it bent pretty good. And basically, I could look at my own finger and find the creases in my own finger and then come up here and put the creases in this finger. You know, and they don't have to be perfect. I'm sure not everybody's creases in their fingers are the same. So you can put a crease in there and maybe another one down here somewhere. Just put a little notch in there. And then while we're carving it down, we can work them down as they go. Well, it's starting to get to look. I'll just whittle her down a little smaller and smaller. We'll try to get this and this in here. Look at her. We're starting to get a pretty good shape of a old looking finger here. Kind of hard to go in and out on these to cut these dips in here. It's a little bit hard, but I'll get the sandpaper out and sand it up. We'll try to get that fingernail a little bit better. I did this fingernail and it turned out pretty good if you ask me. This one here is a little fatter, but it don't matter. So we'll get it the best we can here. Yeah, it's starting to look like a finger. I don't know what kind of finger, but it's a finger. Now we're getting it down there. It's still a little fat. We're working on it. And it's getting down there pretty good. It's looking a little different than the other one. I don't know if I can get any thinner or not, but I'm going to work on it. But I got to watch this too, this hole we cut in there, you know, I don't want to hit it. Now, there's a little piece of copper I put on here, and it's just 3/4 inch copper tubing, and I took a pipe cutter and cut a ring off, and that's what I did here. I don't have any brass, and I don't know where everybody gets the brass pipe at, or the tubing or whatever, but I just been sanding it down, trying to get it cleaned up, and then I'll buff it out real good. And what we're going to do is we got to work this in here to where it'll set down in there, and that'll help that wood from splitting when you're cutting. So I got to get that down on top of here. So that's what I'm working on now. I'll try to get that sized. Once I get that sized, I'll try to take the finger down a little bit more and get it to where it looks a little better. But it's getting there. Well, you could see there, we buffed up the ring a little bit. That's that copper ring. And we kind of just whittled this down till we could get that copper ring on there. And like I said, that's going to hold the wood, help the wood from splitting when you're carving with your knife. And we're working on this creepy looking finger. It's not too bad. So we'll be getting on the blade here pretty soon. I'm still going to do some cleaning up on this finger. I think it looks pretty good, but I'm going to get a little cleaning up. And I think this thing needs down just a little bit. What I might do is go ahead and mount that on there and kind of sand that off there so it's smooth. Then we'll get to working on our blade. Alright, the first thing we're going to do with this Sawzall blade is we're going to take all the teeth off this thing. Now, once we got all the teeth off of it, we're just going to straighten out this edge. Just going to try to get it as straight as we can. We got it roughed out here a little bit. I was going to take the water grinder here and see if I can get a little bit, get it down a little more. I might have to take a file over it. I'm trying to get it to look as good as I can. I'm going to take a file over it a little bit. Well, the file's sure working pretty good. So we'll just keep working on it with the file here. Okay, I've been sanding and carving and everything, and this is what we've come up with so far on that handle. It's not too bad. I think it looks pretty good for a finger. A little different than the other one. And the blade, I've just narrowed this down to 3/8 of an inch, so it would fit inside of my hole. It has to fit inside there. It's a little snug, but we got it down in there. And I got the blade the best that I can. Now, I haven't made very many blades. It's only the second one, and this is the only second thing I think I've ever carved. I've never really carved anything in too much of anything. So, and then I got this is that copper ring, 3/4 inch copper tubing. I cut it out and it'll fit on there like this. And then our blade will fit down in here like this. And we'll get it glued together. And we'll have another knife ready to go. And like I said, this is flat on this sharp end down here. And this is dull on this end. And my other one is just the opposite of that one. I'll grab it for you. And this is the other one, see? It's sharp on this end and dull on that end. So then we got two of them here. And this one here looks like you got a little arthritis, but I think it gives us some character. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna put a little bit of glue on this thing. We're gonna get this glued in here. And then I have to clean the edge up on there just a little bit around this edge here. It's a little bit big. So I'm just going to clean that up and get that glued on there. And then we'll start gluing our blade in. Now, I've been using a Gorilla Glue. I don't know if that's the right glue to use or not, but it worked on my ginseng digger, so I'm going to use it on this too. And I noticed that it actually swells up a lot. And kind of leaves a mess, but we'll probably be sanding that off anyhow. If I wanted to get all that extra glue off of there, well, I could. Anyhow, we'll let that set up, and then we'll clean that edge off of here. Then we'll be ready to glue our blade down in there, and then we're going to get some clear on this thing, like we did the other one. Well, we got our little piece glued on there. Didn't turn out too bad, but we're just trying to get the wood flush with it so it looks a little better. As you can see, we got our little piece glued on there, and I just took the little knife and just whittled that down just about level with that piece of copper, and I was going around it sanding it. And I'm not about to sit here and show you me sanding for 5 hours and wasting your time. So that's what I'm doing. Okay, our next step, I got this ring glued on here, and it's set up there pretty good. And now we're going to get the blade inside the knife. Now, it's a 3/8 hole we drilled in there. So what I'm going to do is I have a piece of 3/8 dowel here. I'm going to take it over to the bandsaw and I'm going to cut it right down the middle. and I'm going to cut probably about 3 inches or so. Whatever this knife is goes in the hole. So what I'll do is I'll just pull the knife out, and then that's how much I'm going to split, whatever I need to tap down inside of this thing. So, and then we'll take the glue, and we'll glue inside the hole, and we'll glue the knife, and we'll glue these two pieces that we have, because this will be split in half. And we'll tap them down in there, and then we'll wait for it to dry. And if there be any sticking out, we'll just take a small saw, and we'll cut a little pieces off of there. And then we'll be ready for our polyurethane or whatever we're going to put on it to shine it up. Okay, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to slide this little blade down in here where I want it to sit in there. Then I'm going to grab me a pencil. And I'm going to mark this blade where I want it. So I want the sharp end right there, straight right there. I don't have a wooden vise or anything to put this in. All I have is this metal vise. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap this thing up in some paper towels. And then I'll hopefully won't destroy my wood. Eventually, maybe I'll make some jaws, some wooden jaws for this thing. But right now, we just want to get this thing so we can put our handle in. So we know that's where the knife's gonna go. So what I'm gonna do here, get me some glue. And we're gonna put some glue down in the hole. It's probably gonna make a mess, but get it to come out there. All right. Got some glue in there. We're just gonna waller it around down in there. Get a little more down in the bottom. Waller it around down in there. Then we're gonna take our knife. We're gonna put some on both sides of our knife here. A little bit on that side, and a little bit on this side. I'm going to slide it down in where that mark was that we had. So we're lined up there. Then we're going to take our little pieces of wood, and we're going to put some glue on both sides of them. Some on both sides. And if we get a little bit on the blade, we'll clean it up. No big deal. We'll start that one down in this side. I'm gonna do this one same way. I put a little taper on them boards so they go down in them holes. So, and then I have a little hammer. I have a lot of wood tools, but I don't have many. I have a lot of metal tools. I don't have a lot of wood tools. Just gonna drive this thing down in there as far as we can. Hopefully this glue will get all over everything. I'm gonna wipe some of that glue off. And just keep tapping here. We'll leave a little bit stick up, that way we can clean it up later. We can cut that off and clean it up later. Making a little mess. So we'll wipe off what glue we can. Then once this dries, once this all dries up, we'll come back in and we'll cut them little two little nubs off right there. We'll cut that one off, cut that one off. We'll sand it down, clean it up, and then we'll put our varnish to it or polyurethane, and we'll have a nice looking knife. We're just gonna let this thing set and dry now, so I'll get back to you as soon as this thing gets dried up. Okay. All right, we got that glued in there and we cut that off. I actually just used the other knife and whittled the wood off of there and sanded it down a little bit. So now we'll start getting our clear coat on there. That way we can see what it's going to turn out like. Okay, when I'm doing a little project like this, I got these brushes. And what I did is I just take a pair of scissors and cut a little piece off of it. Because it's not like I'm doing a big project. So I cut a little piece and I could use that quite a few times. So I don't need much to... much of a brush to put the clear coat on this. So, and we'll do several coats. We get it looking like it's thick on there, and I just cut that brush up and use it a bunch of different times. Now, it never looks good the first coat. It's gonna soak in, and but it'll start looking a little better the more coats we get on it. So, but just cutting that little piece off of there works out pretty good because you don't need much. It's such a small project. And instead of buying a bunch of different brushes, we'll just cut one up and use it. Save money. No use in using one big brush for this little dinky project. Now, I put that clear coat, I put it right over that piece of copper there. I don't know if it's gonna hurt it or not, but it's my brush. I don't care. It's my knife. So get a nice little coat on there and let that soak in, and when it dries we'll come back and put a couple, probably about four coats on there, make it look nice and thick and heavy, almost like a glass. So, but this little brush, I'll just throw it away each time I use it. I'll pitch it in the garbage. It's just a little piece of foam anyhow. So. I think that looks pretty good on there. And I'll actually put some up underneath here on the bottom of it too. I might, next time I put in our coat, I'll bring that blade out of there a little bit more so I could get it up in there a little better. So we'll just let that set there and dry, and then we'll get us another coat on it. We'll keep doing coats until we get a good heavy coat on there. As you can see, it keeps soaking in, especially on the edge of that wood. Okay, we took some steel wool over this thing, and what we're going to do now is give us a second coat. I wanted to get up underneath this edge here. I don't think I got very good the first coat. We took some steel wool over it and took the shine out of it, and we're just going to put this another coat on here. We'll do this about four times. It'll have a really, really good deep shine to it. And every coat, I take steel wool and go over it with steel wool every coat. That way, kind of takes the shine out of it so it'll stick. Not bad for a third coat. Every time I coat it, I take that steel wool and go over it and make sure it's dulled out. So, looking good. Well, the knives are done. I got two of them there. Don't forget, it started out like this and ended up with something like this. It's not a bad little knife. And then we got another one here, and the blades are just the opposite. This one's straight on this side, and this one's got a curve on this side. I probably could have got this in a little bit straighter right through there, but yeah, it's the first thing I've ever carved, and I figured make it a little different, make them fingers, kind of looks cool. So I hope you guys enjoyed my video. Don't forget to subscribe, leave me a comment. Maybe we can whittle out something else with these finger knives. But you know, I was gonna temper, I actually tempered this blade here. They were Sawzall blades, and I did keep them cool when I was grinding them. I kept them in the water. I tempered this one, but I didn't temper this one. I'm gonna see if this one holds an edge, you know, just as good. And I think it will, because they're both made out of hardened steel. But they are sharp. You can see I was actually trying it out, and it actually shaved your arm. So they definitely keep an edge. I mean, they're pretty sharp. So hopefully we can carve a little bit of something with it. Like I said, thanks for watching the video. And don't forget to subscribe or leave me a comment. Till next time.